Where's the Albrecht woman? You know you're supposed to stay with her at all times.
Having a shower.
You left her alone?
Thought she'd be all right. All the other women are at work, aren't they?
You stupid ox. Has Albrecht come out of there?
I just came in here myself.
What happened? I asked you, what happened?
I don't know, I just...
Now get to your cell and stay there until you're sent for. Call Mrs. Davidson. Tell her to get here at once.
Is Dr. Clements going to show you this thesis before it's published?
I've no idea what Dr. Clements is likely to do. Erica Davidson. What? I'm on my way. Get Dr. Miller and don't touch anything.
What happened?
Bella Albrecht's been found in the showers, dead.
I'll call the police.
No, get B. Smith. I'll handle everything else.
Right.
And don't tell anyone about this. We don't want a panic on our hands. How did you find her, Vera?
Well, Eaves was working alone in the garden. When I asked her where Albrecht was, she said she was having a shower. I realized she could have been in danger, so I came running back. When I reached the reception area, I heard Cross scream from in here.
Melinda was in there with the body?
Yes, she must have found it. Oh, well, you don't think that she had anything to do with
no,
it?
No, of course not.
No, it would have been Smith. She's just the sort of animal...
Vera,
that...
I wouldn't make any accusations unless you had any definite proof. This is far too serious a matter. What was Eaves doing in the garden alone? Why wasn't she guarding Albrecht? Has she been instructed?
Oh, the woman's a moron. Well, I suppose it was stupid to trust Albrecht's safety to her in the first place.
We weren't exactly putting all our trust in her. The idea was to keep her away from the other women.
Well, somebody got to her.
Well, Dr. Miller?
I'm afraid there's not much doubt it's murder.
Then we must call the police.
It's not going to look too good, is it?
Well, where's B? That fat bitch is always leaning on me about bludgeon. Now I'm here on time and she's wandering around somewhere else.
So what? I don't mind having time to have a fag in peace.
And Monty isn't here neither. What, do they expect us to do the whole bloody lot on our own?
Oh, shut up, Noeline. You're getting on me goat with all your whinging.
Just watch how you talk to me, Lizzie. Otherwise, I might fix you so you can't talk at all. I'll hide your teeth.
Where's Smith?
Who cares?
Any idea where she is, Lizzie?
Don't know. Perhaps you fancy me seeing you in such a hurry.
Last time I seen her, she and Monty were saying something about going and having showers. This time of the day.
What's going on? Everybody's racing around like blue-eyed flies.
Come on.
Oh, yeah, where are we going?
You're going to be locked in your cell.
What for? I haven't done nothing.
Get moving.
Hey, listen, watch you. You're pushing
come
around.
On.
I do. I haven't bloody done anything.
What do you reckon Monty's been up to this time?
I don't know, but it looks like she's in real trouble.
Well, shall we join the ladies?
Oh, Inspector Allen.
Mrs. Davidson, this is Detective Sergeant Bates.
I'm glad you're here.
Yes, well, where's the body?
In there.
Thank you.
Still can't find Smith, but I've locked Ferguson in a cell.
Why did you do that?
Well, she was late getting to the laundry, and Bourke said she'd heard Smith and Ferguson saying something about showers.
You've got an idea who could be responsible for this?
Well, there's a fairly obvious suspect. She was heard threatening the dead woman.
And she has murdered twice before.
I see. Well, I suggest we go to your office, Mr. Davidson, and I'd like to speak to the woman that you say you've got locked in her cell.
Right.
And the other woman, too, if she can be found as quickly as possible.
Miss Bennett, bring B. Smith to my office immediately.
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
This way, Inspector.
Thank you. Get in touch with Forensic, get them here straight away, and then join us in the governor's office. I'm sure somebody will be able to show you where it is.
Hey, Vera, what's going on? Doc shot through on me, left me here starkers. I've got goosebumps now where I can't mention my bum's numb from the cold.
Smith, you're wanted in the governor's office immediately.
Oh, really? Should I come as I am or dress for the occasion?
Oh, hurry up and put something on. It's urgent.
Oh, isn't it lovely to be wanted?
What am I supposed to have done?
We just want you to answer some questions, Ferguson. What were you doing when the work bell went?
If you must know, I was in the loo.
Why were you so late getting back to the laundry?
I wanted to get me cardi. It's so cold in here, it's enough to freeze the you-know-what's off a brass monkey. Now, listen, what's going on? It's got something to do with Bella, hasn't it?
What made you ask that?
Thought I heard a name mentioned. Well, look, you're barking up the wrong tree if you think I had anything to do with it. B can tell you that. I was with her all the morning.
B?
B. Smith, the woman I mentioned earlier.
Ah. Now, you say that...
I found Smith.
Oh, there you are, Molly. Thought you were having a shower. Something's going on. I can feel it in me bones. Well, why doesn't somebody tell us something? Hey, do you know what's going on?
She's dead.
Who? Not Molly. Not Bee. Come on, love. Tell us.
It's Bella. Someone's murdered her.
Oh, well, that'll be the bloody end of Queen Bee, won't it? After all the threats she made against Bella, I reckon that'll get rid of Bee.
How do you know? How do you know? Who told you?
I was the one that found her. Oh, God, it was horrible. I must have screamed, I don't remember. I just felt sick and dizzy.
Oh, come on, love, tell us more.
I just walked into the shower and there she was, staring at me.
God, I forgot you was preggers. You feel all right?
I feel awful.
Oh, come on, love. I'll take you to the dock.
It's my trial today. How am I going to face it now?
Oh, you'll be all right. Come on.
Tell them you found the body. It'll be a real tearjerker. Might help get you off. I reckon they ought to give whoever done it a medal. Even if it wasn't Bee, they'll blame her. I couldn't have done a better job myself.
Dr. Miller? Oh, yes, Inspector. Yes, B. Smith was with me at that time.
I see. Doctor, what, in your opinion, was the cause of Albrecht's death?
She probably drowned, but there was a bad bruise at the back of the neck and an abrasion to one side.
I see. Well, I'm waiting on the official autopsy report from the pathologist. As soon as I get it, I'd like to discuss it with you, Doctor. Thank you.
Lizzie, don't you ever knock.
Melinda's crook.
Where is she?
Outside. She nearly fainted on me. I knew I couldn't hold her up with me poor old ticker. She found Bella's body, you see. Horrible, she said it was. Enough to give anybody the heebie-jeebies. It would have killed me, I reckon. Oh, I would have dropped down with a shock, seeing those big eyes wide open staring at me. Must have been awful.
Yeah. All right, Lizzie, just leave me alone to attend to Melinda, will
but
you?
But I want to help. I mean, I brought her here.
Thank you. I can manage quite well on my own. Thank you,
well,
Lizzie.
Well, that's the last person I'm ever going to bring to you. They can bloody well drop dead for all I care.
Just take these, Melinda. They'll help you feel better. Melinda. Are you in any pain? Hey, calm down. You're going to be all right.
God, I hate this place. What if they find me guilty? I'll kill myself.
Hey, now, hold on. You haven't been sentenced yet.
My father's coming to see me this afternoon before I go to court. Could you speak to him? Get him to testify for me?
Surely he'll be there, won't he?
I don't know. Maybe he's changed his mind. He wouldn't raise bail when I was first arrested. Maybe he won't support me this time. Oh, please talk to him.
Look, I think you'd better come into the hospital and lie down. Those pills will help you sleep. When your father arrives, I'll ask him to be sent to me, all right?
Now, listen, I only said I was with B because I guess there was something wrong with Bella and I thought B would be the first suspect. I didn't go back to the showers after I was told to wait the first time.
But you were late getting to the laundry.
Look, I told you, I went back to my cell to get a cardigan. I also changed my jumper because I was itchy. That's why I was late.
Mr. Fletcher, when you went to the laundry looking for Smith, tell us what one of the women said to you.
Why, she mentioned that she'd heard Smith and Ferguson talking about going to the showers.
Yeah, well, I just happened to say that I hoped I'd get a shower later on today, but I didn't go back to the showers then.
Even your friend said she thought you were taking a shower. Your alibi doesn't stand up very well, does it, Ferguson?
Now, listen, you're not going to pin this on me. I'm up for a release soon. Now, why in hell would I risk that just to bump off some rotten bitch?
Do you deny that you attacked Albrecht in the garden yesterday?
No, of course not. But there's a hell of a difference between trying to thump somebody and killing them.
Albrecht was thumped before she was drowned. Perhaps that's what you, all you did, Ferguson. You thumped her, she fell in the water, and you left her there, didn't you?
No, I didn't. I didn't touch her.
You'll be detained on suspicion of murder, pending further inquiries.
Mr. Fletcher, take Ferguson to solitary, please.
No, I didn't do it. You've got to believe me. I didn't do it.
That's enough, Ferguson. Go along quietly.
Come on, Ferguson.
Yeah, can I go too? I haven't got anything else I can tell you.
Stay where you are, Smith. It is my belief, Inspector, that this woman incited the murder. Ever since she found out that Albrecht was a child killer, she has threatened continually to fix her.
I didn't
do it. Smith was warned that if she didn't behave herself, she would be transferred to another prison. However, she seemed to take no notice of these warnings and was, in fact, with Ferguson in the garden yesterday when she attacked Albrecht.
I wasn't in that. I tried to stop Monnie.
Miss Bennett, did you see Smith intervene in any way?
No, she just stood and watched. It's my opinion that she incited Ferguson to attack Albrecht.
That is a filthy lie.
In fact, I've heard Smith make many verbal threats against Albrecht.
Thank you, Miss Bennett.
You'll be detained on suspicion of inciting a murder.
Put Smith in solitary, Miss Bennett.
So I told an officer to call for Mrs. Davidson while I stood guard by the body.
Matter of locking the stable door, wasn't it, after the horse had well and truly bolted? There's one thing I don't understand. Why, if Albrecht was in danger, was she left alone in the showers this morning?
Eaves was supposed to be with her.
Eaves?
Martha Eaves. Albrecht was always very carefully guarded when she was in contact with the other prisoners, but she was considered to be safe alone with Martha Eaves. Eaves had become friendly with her and was quite capable of protecting her as she did in the garden yesterday.
Well, why wasn't Eaves in the shower with her this morning?
I haven't had a chance to ascertain that as yet.
Eaves is waiting outside to be questioned.
We'll bring her in.
Inside.
What are you picking on me for? I haven't done nothing to no one. I was Bella's friend. It's not fair you accusing me.
No one is picking on you, Martha, and no one has even said you are a suspect. Inspector Allen just wants to ask you a few questions.
Why should you think that anything's happened to Bella?
Not that dumb. It's all over the prison.
When did you last see Bella?
In the shower room. She told me to push off, so I did. I went back to work in the garden.
Was there anybody else in the showers?
Don't think so.
What do you mean, you don't think so? Either there was or there wasn't.
Could have been hiding someplace. I don't know. All I know is Bella was alive when I left. I don't know nothing else.
I'm afraid Melinda won't be able to see you today, Mr. Cross. She's waiting to be questioned by the police.
Police? What's she done now?
Oh, no, she's not in any trouble. It's purely a routine matter.
Well, she'd better not be in any more trouble. Not if she wants my help. I've had just about enough of her.
Is that why you refused to put up bail for her?
Yes. She's let down the whole family. Behaved like a common slut. I don't even know whether I ought to testify for her today.
Mr. Cross,
I believe that Melinda only tried blackmail as a last resort. She discovered she was pregnant to the man she loved. He deserted her, left her alone and afraid.
Well, she had no need to be alone. She could have come back to me.
She wasn't thinking rationally. All she knew was that you loved the father of her child, loved him too much to lose him. She had to get him back, not only for her sake, but for the sake of her baby.
What she asked for was $5,000.
Yes, but surely you can understand that was only a ploy. An attempt to break up her lover's marriage so that he'd return to her and face the responsibility of being the father of her child.
Blackmail's a hell of a way to get your man back.
Well, as I said, she wasn't thinking rationally. Her concern for her unborn baby was overwhelming. Mr. Cross, Melinda needs the support of her family now more than ever before. If she's convicted today, her baby will be born in prison. I'm sure you don't want that for your grandchild.
No. No, you're right. I don't want that. Well, you can tell Melinda that I'll be in court today to do whatever I can.
Poor little thing. She nearly fainted on me. I don't reckon she's strong enough to stand trial this afternoon.
It's all an act, if you ask me.
Well, nobody asked you.
Yeah, she'll stand up there and she'll look all pathetic and cry a lot, and the judge will feel sorry for her. And she'll probably put it over the lot of them.
Just the same, I hope she does get off. Seems to me she's suffered enough.
What is this? Be kind to silly little bitches week.
Oh, that's your trouble. You've never felt sorry for anyone.
Listen, you old bat. I'm going to knock the stuffing out of you. Oh. That's the second crack you've had at me today. The third will be your last.
Oh, Martha, have you seen the police? What can you tell us?
Yeah, I've just been interviewed by the D's and I might have to give evidence in court at Monty and B's trial.
Monty and B? What do you mean?
They're both in the pound under suspicion.
Come on, you lot. What do you think you're playing at? Get back to work. Eaves, why aren't you in the garden?
Thought the police might need me again.
You can be called just as easy from in the garden.
I want to see the governor.
The governor's busy.
I've got to see her. It's urgent. I've got to tell her something about the murder.
All right, Eaves, wait in the garden until you're told otherwise.
Are you going to take me to see the governor or shall I go by myself?
All right, Lizzie, but it'd better be good.
What is it?
You can take me in, Constable. I'm the one that did the murder.
You needn't handcuff Lizzie, Sergeant. I'm quite sure she didn't murder Bella.
I might look a sweet, gentle old woman, but I'm as tough as nails when I'm riled, and I'm a dab hand with the rat poison. I've already killed 4 men.
Albrecht wasn't poisoned, Lizzie. And you do not have the strength to have killed Bella in the way in which she died.
Oh.
Detective Sergeant Bates, would you mind waiting outside for a moment, please?
As you wish.
Sit down, Lizzie. Why are you claiming to have murdered Bella?
It's my business.
I know. You were trying to save Monica and Bea, weren't you? Well, that's very brave and very generous of you, Lizzie.
But Monty and Bea didn't do it. And I don't want them to get into trouble. But that wasn't all.
Well, what was it, Lizzie? Come on, you can tell me.
Before she died, Edie told me what it was like being on the outside. Poor, lonely old woman. Nowhere to go. No one to care for. I don't want to be like that, Mrs. Davidson. In here, I got a warm bed, 3 meals a day, and I got me friends. Me real friends. I couldn't bear to be without them. And on the outside, what could I do?
And you thought that if you were convicted of Bella's murder, you could spend the rest of your time here. Well, it's not so frightening on the outside, Lizzie. There are people who could help you.
That's not all life is about. It's no good being helped. You have to be wanted. Edie knew that. What would I be good for, Mrs. Davidson? Please don't make me leave. Please, Mrs. Davidson.
About time you rang. Been bored stupid. Yeah, the social worker left at 9. Oh yeah, the screw had the morning off. She left an hour ago. You can come round now. Yeah, some good grog. And we got the stereo. And yeah, well, there's the double bed.
Morning.
Morning.
Just a minute. Thanks, Ted. Thanks, Mrs. Jackson.
Oh, you're back early?
Yeah, my lecture was cancelled for this afternoon. The day I went to trial.
The charge against Melinda isn't quite as serious as yours was.
Still, I bet she's a bundle of nerves. I hope it works out for her.
You've heard the news, Meg?
Yes, Vera rang me.
Karen, would you go straight to my office, please? The police want to interview you. It's all right. You're not a suspect. It's just a routine interview.
How's Melinda? Vera told me that she was the one who found the body.
She's very shaken, poor girl. It's a pity this had to happen on the day of a trial.
She's been completely dismissed as a suspect.
Oh, yes, it's pretty clear who did it.
I find it very hard to believe that Ferguson would go that far.
I wouldn't have thought so either. Looks as though we were both wrong.
Murdered?
I'm afraid so. When did you last see Albrecht?
Last night. She came into my room and we talked for a while.
Did she seem fearful at all?
No, she seemed quite confident. She felt sure that Martha would protect her from the other women.
What did she talk to you about?
Well, about what she'd done. Killing the baby. I think she just wanted someone to talk to.
She was remorseful for what she'd done?
No, not really. She just wanted company. Martha's not much of a conversationalist.
Why did she choose you to talk to?
Well, I never treated her badly, and I guess she felt I'd understand.
Why should she think that? You're not in for baby killing, are you?
No, but I had an abortion.
Yes, well, did you ever overhear anyone threatening Albrecht?
No.
You're sure?
Quite sure. Am I interrupting?
Not at all, Mrs. Davidson. Please come in. That's all, thank you. Well, there's not much more I can do here until we have the official autopsy. Everything's pretty well cut and dried. A bit too cut and dried. There's one thing.
What's that?
That scratch on Albrecht's body, as if something had been torn from around the neck. A necklace, perhaps.
Hmm.
Well, we'll take our leave for now, Mrs. Davidson. We'll be back.
Goodbye, gentlemen.
What are you staring at?
They're bees things. I think you should leave them alone.
Well, do you just. Only wanted a fag. She won't be needing them where she's going.
What are you talking about?
Haven't you heard? Gone and gotten herself into dead trouble this time.
Who, Bee?
And Monnie. Got themselves stuck with Bella's murder.
Oh, that's ridiculous. There must have been others with a motive.
Like what?
I don't know. Someone just wanted to get them into trouble.
Who'd want to do it so much that they'd go and bump somebody off? And do you know what time is?
I don't know. 3:30, 4 o'clock.
Do you know if that Vernon bitch has left yet?
I haven't seen her, but I shouldn't think so. I
hope she's still around.
I love him. I love Tom so much. And I'll love his baby. It's all I have of him now.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, my client, still badly shaken from the traumatic experience of finding the body of a murdered woman, has had to stand in the dock and bear her soul to this courtroom. Well, she has done so bravely and with honesty, admitting her crime, but letting us see a glimpse of the inner turmoil that drove her to it. She's a young girl, little more than a child, brought up in the country, unused to the city's sophisticated ways. Yes, this young girl was an easy mark for the unscrupulous man who professed to love her. She was too naive, too inexperienced to even take simple contraceptive measures. She soon became pregnant, and the baby she carried became her only concern. Deserted by her lover and wanting so desperately to have a father for the child, she took the ill-advised step of blackmail. She wasn't interested in the money. No, that meant nothing to her, as you have heard her swear. She loves Thomas Burton and will love his baby. Now, we all know how far a woman's maternal instincts can drive her in the protection of her young. I now leave it to you to decide whether this young girl, who has already suffered a great deal of mental torment, should have to suffer even further.
Must be nice to be able to put on your coat and go home.
Yes, well, I do any work here. Can I do something for you?
Yeah, I want to see Leanne.
The last time you saw Leanne, she ended up running away in tears.
It wouldn't have happened if you'd kept your nose out of things.
I was only trying to help.
Yeah, well, you can help now. I want to make it up with her, see?
Good. I'll bring Leanne in. I'm sure she'd like to make it up with you, too.
You, Melinda Jane Cross, have been found guilty of blackmail, a serious offence in the eyes of the law, and a particularly distasteful and cowardly act in the eyes of society. However, there are extenuating circumstances. Counsel has pleaded that you acted as you did out of the ill-founded belief that your threats would result in securing a father for your child. You certainly have no previous record of any similar criminal or even malicious behavior. The very fact that you are with child has also strongly influenced my decision. It is a sad thing indeed for a baby to be born in custody. Fortunately, this will not have to happen in your case. You will be released on a good behavior bond. Recognizance of $500 to be of good behavior for a period of 3 years and to come up for sentence if and when called upon. Do you understand what that means? It means that if you commit a further offense during the next 3 years, you will not only forfeit your bond, but may be sentenced for this crime. Do you agree to this?
Yes, I do.
You may step down.
Leanne? What's going on in there? What the hell is going on? Oh, will you just look at this place?
Had a friend around. Had to entertain him, didn't I?
Well, you can just get him out of Meg's bedroom and out of the flat.
Oh, he's gone. Went out the window.
Oh. I've got a message from your mother.
You know what you can do with that, don't you?
She's still your mother, Leanne.
I'm doing all right without her, and I don't want to know.
Well, you may think that you're doing all right, but you can't stay here forever. In fact, if Meg comes home and sees this place like this, you'll be right out on your ear.
You wouldn't let her do that to me.
Don't press your luck.
What did Mum want?
She wants to make it up with you. I think she's feeling pretty sorry about that row you had with her.
She was pretty nasty.
Well, she wants to say she's sorry.
That'll be the day.
At least go and see her and find out. You may be surprised. Well?
Yeah, all right. But if she gets stuck into me, she's going to be real sorry.
Geez, you're pretty good at sneaking up on people, aren't you?
What do you want me to do, knock?
I suppose it's your room as much as mine.
Oh, gee, thanks.
You really like playing the professor, don't you? Hey, maybe if you asked them real nicely, they might give you an office of your own, just like one of the screws.
I just want to study, do you mind?
What's wrong? Rec room not good enough for you.
Too much noise with Lizzie and Martha raving on.
The big M. When did she ever get to rub two words together?
Well, she seems to think she's going to be star witness at Ben Monica's trial.
I wouldn't be surprised if she'd done it herself.
Who, Martha?
Yeah, why not? She had more chance than the rest of us.
Was she like Bella?
Nah, I reckon she just liked the fact that Bella was being nice to her.
Well, one way or another, what motive would she have?
Oh, there you go again. Motive. You don't need a motive to bump someone off.
You might.
What's that supposed to mean?
Nothing.
Martha's dumb enough to do it just for the hell of it. Come to think of it, most of them in here are.
Yeah, except you, of course.
Listen, are you trying to say something?
We just seem very anxious to pin the blame on someone.
So you reckon I did it? You reckon I killed poor little Bella? Jeez, you're dumb, Karen. You're as stupid as the rest of them. Now listen, I'll tell you something. There's killers and there's crims. I don't care what your books say. They're not the same. Well, not too often anyway. Now take you. Now you're no crim, but you bumped off your husband. Now Lizzie, she's a crim, but she only meant them shearers she poisoned to get sick. And me? Well, I'm no killer. I'm more of your Robin Hood, taken from the rich to give to the poor, namely me.
Well, according to you, that lets Martha off the hook. She's just a thief.
Don't be such a smartass. Martha is as dumb as an ox, and that's the difference between a killer and a real crim like me. Books! You don't learn nothing from books!
Well, and how did the trial go? Pretty well, obviously.
Yeah, they put me on a good behaviour bond for 3 years.
Good. Well, that's very good. Take a seat.
Thanks.
So, what are your plans now?
I'm going to go back to uni. I've got a while to go before I get my degree. And just stay out of trouble, I suppose.
Right. You're living at home, I take it?
No, not exactly.
Well, you're going to find it very hard to manage on your own once the baby arrives. I mean, it's a good idea to keep on your studies, but who's going to look after the kid and what do you do for money?
Actually, that's what I wanted to talk to you about.
Oh?
Well, Dad pays rent on the flat, so that's okay.
Yes?
Oh, by the way, I'm sure Dad's testimony helped a lot. Thanks for talking to him.
That's okay. Glad I could help.
You did. He was really impressed with you. Thought you were a bright young man.
Yes, well, fathers do tend to go on like that. Look, what can I do to help you?
It's about the baby. Mm-hmm. It's going to be a bit of a problem.
Actually, you know, I think you'd do much better to consult an obstetrician. I mean, I'm qualified to deal with maternity cases, but I'm not very experienced in that, and I think you'd be better off with specialist care. I know someone I can recommend. I'll give you his address.
But I don't want an obstetrician.
Huh?
No, you see, in a way, it was a good thing being pregnant. Let's face it, it's the only reason I didn't get a sentence, because the judge didn't want the kid to be born in custody. But it still leaves me with the problem of looking after it. That's not going to be easy.
Yeah, that's true. Have you discussed this with your parents?
Well, Dad wants me to have the kid, of course, but he'd be useless looking after it, even assuming my stepmother would allow it into the house. We don't exactly get on.
I see. So you're thinking of adoption. Yes, I can understand your dilemma. Look, the best thing you can do is talk to a social worker, someone like Jean Vernon, for instance, and give yourself a little while to think it over. You may decide later that you'd prefer to keep the child. Look, you're probably a bit panicky at the moment. Leave it for a few days. It'll all fall into perspective.
I don't think you understand, Doctor. I'm not panicky, and I'm not talking about adoption. I never had any intention of keeping the baby. It served its purpose. Now I want an abortion.
Yes. Yes, I see. Right. Thank you. Come in. Oh, good morning, Dr. Miller.
Good morning.
The police have just been on the phone. I have the pathologist's report. It confirms with your diagnosis, death by drowning. The police are coming back to re-question some of the women.
I didn't come here to discuss the pathologist's report, Mrs. Davidson.
Oh?
No. Okay, I know this is a bad time for you, and I'm sorry, but I'm afraid I shall be discontinuing my visits to the prison as of this week.
Well, that's rather sudden.
Not really. I did warn you I should be needing to devote all my time to my own practice.
Yes, I know, but we had hoped you would continue here until we found a regular medical officer.
We both know that that could be months yet, Mrs. Davidson, and I'm just not prepared to stay here that long.
What is it, Dr. Miller? You seem to be upset about something.
Quite frankly, I'm sick and tired of being used by unscrupulous women who play on my sympathy for their own ends.
What's happened?
I'm afraid I can't discuss that, Mrs. Davidson, but I'm thoroughly fed up, and the sooner I get out of here, the better it will be for all of us.
Well, for you, perhaps, but not for us. It will be very difficult to replace you. Well, obviously no point in my arguing with you. You seem to have made up your mind. All I can do is thank you for your excellent work here and wish you the very best of luck in your new practice.
I'm sorry, I really am.
Goodbye, Dr. Miller.
Goodbye.
Inspector Allen, the governor's expecting me.
Yes, would you just sign on, please? I'll let the governor know you're here.
No need. Another way.
Hi.
Well, young lady. I hope you left the place in a better condition than the one I found it in when I came home last night.
What do you mean? We cleaned it up before you got home.
That may be your idea of clean, but it's certainly not mine. It looked like a pigsty.
Well, you should feel at home then,
Leanne!
Oh, don't worry, Meg. I'll vacuum it tonight.
I doubt whether that'll get the whiskey stains out of the carpet.
Well, I'll get them out somehow.
I know what I would rather you got out.
Meg, would you mind telling Noeline that Leanne's here?
She's already waiting in the interview room. Your mother seems very anxious to see you. God knows why.
Mrs. Jackson, send Travers to my office, please.
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
Don't tell me Karen's study release has been suspended again.
No, she just had to stay back this morning. The police want to question her further.
But how could she know anything about Bella's murder? She wasn't even here at the time.
Come on, Leanne.
You just make sure you get out of that do-gooder's place quick, smart.
Yeah, it was you who said I couldn't go home while I was on the dole.
Oh, well, you know what I'm like. I sometimes say these little things that I don't really mean. You know me. You'll forgive your crabby old mum, won't you?
Yeah, sure.
Now, I think you'll find something soon that'll help you get off the dole, and then you'll be able to go home and help the whole family.
Okay. All right, if I go now?
Yeah. You run along like a good little girl. Just remember, the family welfare's in your hands now.
Oh, Karen, it seems that you were the only one that Albrecht tried to confide in.
Well, only a little.
Tell me, did you ever see Albrecht with a necklace of any kind?
This is very important, Karen.
I think she did wear a chain round her neck. It was to hold her engagement ring.
Can you describe this ring for me?
I only saw it once. It looked very expensive. I think it was a ruby set in diamonds.